And we started with a little project at agency. We called it Art for Peace. And one of the aims and the main aims of the institution is promote peace and harmony.
Art has played a role in the liberation of our country. And art has been in the forefront of transforming society and communities.
Based in Sarawak, in Pretoria. And this will be my first exhibition in Joburg here.
The word peace caught my mind because I experienced something which is not good, and I always seek for peace in my heart. And I said, no, I must express myself through my art to seek for that peace.
I'm a stone sculptor. I'm from Zim. I get my inspiration through nature, Mother Nature.
We have a lovely time in our studio developing new works. I think this craft found me, and I think it was kind of my calling.
My field of photography is I love people. I love to try and capture a person's essence with my camera.
We need to make space for each other, and that sense of coming together and harmony and humility and making space for each other so that we can connect and grow, I think has certainly been the theme for me in all my engagements with the Turquoise Harmony Institute.
The first getting something to do with the organization was last year when you came to visit me at the University of Pretoria. And it was so wonderful from the beginning to feel that even though we come from different religious traditions, there's a common bond between us.
The Turquoise Harmony Institute, they have an art of bringing together people from such diverse backgrounds and contexts and experiences. And that for me is the manifestation of that unity and diversity.
So with the inspiration that we see here around us, there is hope in this country. French Garden, 1986. He said, hope against hope. It looks like it. There's no more hope, but there's still hope in this country. There's still good people. We just have to stand up all together and hold hands. He said, to harm before it is too late. Let us join forces and claim peace in the streets of our country.
And we hope you are going to keep us in your prayers, that we are going to utilize this office for the betterment of everyone in the country.